In this video, we're going to talk about some of the basics of structural equation modeling, and more specifically, how to do structural equation modeling in Lavaan, which is the R package that Genomic SEM uses to estimate the models. To start, let's go over some of the basic model syntax for Lavaan, beginning with how to specify a regression relationship, which you could write as Y tilde X, which visually depicted as a path diagram would mean X predicting Y with this single-headed area. Depending on how you think about variables in your model, you might think of that as reflecting A tilde B, dependent tilde independent, outcome tilde predictor. But of course, you would name these according to the actual names of the variables in your data set. This is just to drive home the point that the outcome is on the left-hand side of this equation and the predictor is on the right-hand side of the tilde over here. To specify a variance of a variable, you would write the name of that variable twice with two tildes in between. So X tilde tilde X would specify the variance of X or the covariance of X with itself. To specify the covariance between two different variables, you would also use two tildes. And on the right-hand side, you would write the name of that second variable, in this case, Y, which is a path diagram would reflect this two-headed arrow between X and Y. And in the standardized case would of course reflect the correlation between these two variables. To specify factor loadings, which refers to the regression relationships between this unobserved latent factor and these observed variables A through E, which we'll talk a little bit more about later in this presentation, you would write F and then equal sign tilde and then A through E. You can name the latent factor however you want. In this case, we've just called it F. And of course, A through E should again reflect whatever the names of the actual variables are in your data set. But this is generally speaking the schematic for how you would specify the factor loadings in a model. Just a note to say that the default behavior in Lavaan is to fix the loading of the first variable to 1. And this is necessary because since F is not a variable in your data set, Lavaan and structural equation modeling more generally needs some sort of anchoring point so that it knows what kind of scale to put this latent factor on. So again, unless you tell it to do otherwise, Lavaan will fix that loading for the first variable to 1 so it knows how to scale the latent factor. And as another note, just in general in structural equation modeling, squares are used to depict observed variables, such as the variables here for A through E, and circles are used to depict unobserved or what is often referred to as latent variables. And that can include latent factors like the latent factor F over here, or for example, the residual variances of observed variables, where the observed variable is something that is observed in your data set and the residual variance is not. And so for that reason, it's generally depicted as a circle. To fix a parameter in a Lavaan model, you would write the value that you're fixing it to on the right-hand side of the equation, followed by an asterisk, and then whatever variable name comes on that side. You always put the value you're fixing it to on the right-hand side, so you would not write 1 star x tilde tilde y. But what this specifically does here is it fixes the covariance between x and y to 1. You can also name a parameter in Lavaan, and to do that, you also put an asterisk on the right-hand side of the equation, but then you would also include whatever you're naming that parameter, which should just be some set of letters. So I could call this dog, cat, A, raindrop. You just have to name it something that doesn't overlap with the actual names of the variables in your data set. So this names the covariance between X and Y to be A, and that's useful because then you can, in the later part of your model, use what is referred to as model constraints for a particular parameter. So let's say that for some reason, you know that X and Y's covariance should be above 0, but you don't know exactly what that number should be. So you're not fixing the value to anything in particular, but you are telling Lavaan that that value should be above this particular number of 0.001. Just a cautionary note on naming parameters. I've seen a number of people use the same parameter label for multiple parts of the model. And oftentimes this was done unintentionally on their part. And the reason that that is a problem is because when you name it with the same label A here, that's not just naming the covariance between X and Y and the covariance between Y and Z. It's also telling Lavaan that you want to fix these two covariances to be estimated at the same value. So if you do want to name multiple parameters in the model, model. You just want to make sure to name them different things, unless you are intentionally trying to use what is referred to generally as an equality constraint. So this is a what not to do, unless you are trying to make these parameters be the same. Having reviewed all these Lavaan basics, I now just want to go through some of the concepts and basics of structural equation modeling, and then continue to use this Lavaan syntax along the way as we review those basics. But to start, I want to begin in this hypothetical space where we're talking about a situation that we would not run into, in which we actually know what the relationships are between the variables. So here, let's say that we know that the regression relationship between X and Y is 0.4, and that Y has a residual variance of 0.84, which would imply this particular set of relationships where Y equals 0.4 times X plus this residual U. If we extend that out to say that we know that Y causes Z at 0.6, that would add on this additional notation of Z equals 0.6 times Y plus U. And so this would imply a particular covariance matrix in the population, this set of relationships, where this is in a standardized space. So on the diagonal, we have the variances of the variables, which are one. And then on the off diagonals, we have the relationship between X and Y at 0.4, between Y and Z at 0.6. And the relationship between X and Z in a structural equation model, in this case, would be 0.4 times 0.6 or 0.24. In practice, we, of course, don't have access to the covariance matrix in the population, but instead we have a particular covariance matrix within a sample, which is intended to be a rough approximation of the population that we're interested in studying. And so, again, in practice, we have this observed covariance matrix in our sample. Instead of knowing these relationships, we're then flipping that process on its head. And we're saying that we want the model to pick the values within this system of relationships that we've specified that most closely approximate the covariance matrix in our sample. Within structural equation modeling, you'll hear people talk about the degrees of freedom of the model. And that refers to how many parameters you estimated relative to how many parameters you could have estimated given the unique elements in the covariance matrix. So for a three-variable covariance matrix, you have 6 unique elements, which refers to the 3 variances on the diagonal and the 3 covariances on the off-diagonal. And in our model, we've only estimated 5 of those parameters, where specifically we did not estimate the regression or covariance relationship between X and Z. So that means we have 1 degree of freedom and can be thought of as specifying a model that provides a more parsimonious or simplified set of relationships relative to what we observe in the data. To specify this model in Lavaan using that notation that we just went over, for the regression relationship between X and Y, we would write Y tilde X over here in blue, and for Y and Z the same thing, but Z tilde Y. So in practice, again, what Lavaan and what SEM softwares are doing more generally is they're taking this observed covariance matrix and the system of relationships that you've specified, and they're picking the numbers that get as close as possible to that observed covariance matrix, which in this case would be 0.35 and 0.61, and that would imply a certain covariance matrix. And the level of difference between these two matrices is often what is used to produce what is referred to as model fit, which is something we'll talk about in later videos. As we talked about earlier, you can also specify latent factors in a data set which reflect the shared variation across a certain set of variables, such as Y1 through Y5 here. And I would just note that we're actually employing a different notation than we used earlier, where we're specifying the factor loadings again with the name of the factor F equals tilde, and then the name of the variables that define the factor. But we're overriding that default Lavaan behavior to fix the indicator of the first variable to 1 by writing NA star Y1. And then we're instead anchoring that part of the model or scaling it by telling Lavaan that we want to fix the latent variance of the factor to 1. So we're using what is referred to as unit variance identification instead of what we used before when we fixed the loading of Y1 to 1, which is referred to as unit loading identification. Not something that you need to keep in your working memory at all times, but just something for you to know as an option. And this particular part can be important if you're specifying, let's say, correlations between factors, where if you set the variance of the factor to 1, then that means they're on a standardized scale and you can interpret those relationships as correlations. Now here we're just showing what if you want to expand this out to include the relationships between two latent factors. And so again, in Lavaan syntax, you would write for the latent factor F1 here, this part of the model here in blue, F1 equals tilde Y1 through Y5. For the regression relationship between F2 and F1, this part here in purple. And for the latent factor model for factor 2, F2 equals tilde Z1 through Z5. What Genomic SEM does is it uses the principles of structural equation modeling to fit a model to the genetic covariance matrix. So it's a two-stage process where in stage one, that genetics covariance matrix and its associated matrix of standard errors and their codependencies are estimated, where we specifically use LD score regression. And in stage two, we fit that structural equation model to the matrices from stage one using Lavaan and the basic principles of structural equation modeling. I know this was a fairly brief overview, but hopefully it provided the basic notation to use Lavaan syntax and understand a little bit about what the SEM process looks like. And so in the next talk, we'll go over how it is that we actually estimate this genetic covariance matrix and that set of standard errors.